guys, Danny here from the Cosmos with another trailer reaction for you today. Just can't have enough Avengers, you know, they keep putting out trailers, just gotta keep watching them, and I can't freaking wait. So today we're reacting to the Avengers Endgame to the End TV spot. So then usually when you hit the TV spot, that's kind of like the last trailer you get. Last time I said I expected that to be the last trailer, but nope, we gotta remember there's always a TV spot. This is like traditionally the last trailer until we hit like accolade trailer, like, hey, it's the number one movie in America. You gotta go see it. But you know what? It's Marvel. They do what they want. Who knows? They could probably throw out 4 more trailers before the movie comes out. Just please don't spoil the movie for me, Marvel. That's all I ask. But yeah, we are going to react to this trailer. I am super hype. And sometimes you just can't be hype enough for the Avengers, you know? So why not throw another trailer to even it increase those levels higher, you know? I can't wait. But without further ado, Marvel Studios Avengers Endgame to the End TV spot.
Heroes. Okay. It's an old-fashioned notion. A visionary, a genius, ensuring freedom around the globe.
Good old Iron Man armor, Cap shield.
A symbol to the nation, a hero to the world.
Winter Soldier is amazing. I love that movie so much.
The beacon of hope.
Ragnarok.
Shining out.
Show off our big guys, you know.
I look around at us. You know what I see?
A bunch of a-holes.
Possibility.
Oh my god.
You know how the world works.
Just the throwback of over 10 years, guys. This is insane.
Is changing.
Wakanda forever!
Heroes.
He said the thing! Oh. No way. He's gonna start. Oh, look at all of them.
Invites challenge. Challenge incites conflict. Conflict breeds catastrophe. The thing isn't beautiful because it lasts.
We're in the end game now.
Oh!
Before we're done, we still have one promise to keep. If you can't protect the Earth, can be damn sure we'll avenge it. Whatever it takes.
Look at all. Okay, is that it? It looks okay. Cool. You know what? I appreciate the trailer a lot because not only did it get me hype and just show me everything from just old movies. The only real new thing we saw was the quick clip of Cap being like, whatever it takes. And then the little fist bump thing. Actually, we might have seen a new thing for Iron Man's suit. But just, oh my god. I'll let it play through. This is so freaking hype. We also see this corridor. I don't think we've seen this corridor empty yet. Each time we've seen it, it's either been like the crew marching in.
It's an old-fashioned notion.
Well, I guess it both in close-ups and wide shots. Oh my god, guys. Just, this is insane. So I guess no better time than now, I guess, to bring it up. Just because on Twitter, I would say this past week, but I've only seen it the last like two, like today and yesterday. There was just this woman on Twitter that retweeted a guy's reaction to the Star Wars trailer. And it was something to the effect of like hashtag make men great again, because yeah, this, that, and the other, Star Wars and superhero movies are making men worthless. I'm paraphrasing, of course, but it was just this whole thing attacking a guy for being really excited for Star Wars. And granted, I saw a lot of personalities, like I follow Alana Pierce, Corey Barlog, just being like, you know, you're wrong. I mean, you're entitled to your opinion, not to think what you want, but it's unfortunate that you find it necessary to bully somebody just because they're really excited for, You know, granted, a nerdy thing. We call these nerdy things. This is super exciting. And I, as someone who just loves the Marvel movies, okay, I'll pause for a bit because I'm getting distracted by all this awesome. My sister has never, she's seen Guardians of the Galaxy and Deadpool, but like she hasn't watched any of these other movies. And I always poke fun at her and mean like, hey, you should watch these movies. Like everybody in the world is watching these movies. Granted, that's a hyperbole, not legitimately everyone. There are people who haven't seen these and there are people who don't like them and don't want to see them. And that's completely understandable. But it's almost like if you don't like it, you're allowed to not like it. But hating on other people for liking it is garbage. It's this awful thing to do. And then going out of your way to share somebody's excitement and be like, wow, what a loser because he's excited for Star Wars. It's just, it's such a sleazy, awful thing. And I hated it. And for a moment there, I like felt attacked in a way. I was just like, I react to these trailers now and I get really excited over, especially the Avengers one. I hate that for that moment, one person's opinion just like put me in a mindset of like, is this worth it? And then I just started scrolling and seeing everybody being like, you're wrong. I don't know why you feel like you need to do this. I mean, you're entitled to your opinion and everything. And I was like, you know what? You're right. Like, there's no reason me enjoying these trailers and me enjoying all this nerdy universe, this amazing thing over 10 years that's been built up by making movie after movie, connecting them all, winding them together. Now, I can't speak for much. You see me react to the Star Wars trailers. I'm just not that in that universe. But I was pretty mad. I got a roller coaster of emotion of being like, oh my God, this guy's so happy. Oh, this woman's attacking him for being happy. Man, maybe she's right. You know what? No, she's not. There's a bunch of people behind me on this that like, we love these things. And not only that, then she goes out of her way to just attack the people who were defending this guy. And it's dumb. It's stupid. And, I haven't gotten involved. I don't intend to get involved. I have no reason to, but, that took a turn. But guys, like what you like. Don't let people stop you from liking what you like, okay? Let's go back to watching this trailer. Oh my God. We'll get to... I noticed the one thing... Now, I'm pretty sure they're showing these in release order. But then... I think at the end they show Captain Marvel before Infinity War. Now, it looks like it goes... Well, it wouldn't even be chronological because Captain Marvel would be like the second or third film. We're in the endgame now. I guess it's just the hype connected Infinity War to Endgame, but in 10 fucking days. We still have one promise to keep. I'm so floored, dude. I am so hyped. Also, and now that I hear it a second time, the way he says that, you can be damn sure we'll avenge it. So if you play, I guess it doesn't sound anything like it did in Avengers, because he was a little more like snarky and upbeat. He was just like, and if we can't save it, be damn sure we avenge it. You know, it's kind of like, and this is just like, you be damn sure we, like, it's a little more intense. If you can't protect the Earth, you can be damn sure we'll avenge it. Yeah, so maybe I'm just crazy, but I imagine that's going to be like, hey, we're going to relive that moment against Loki. And look at these guys. Can't wait. I'm trying to figure out. Oh, I guess that's Rhodey. Okay, I was taking a look. I'm like, everybody has like the same little rectangle shape. And then this one, I'm like, who is that? It's probably just Rhodey. But then now that makes you question if Rhodey just got blue and red armor white and red armor like this. Why doesn't Tony? Is his suit just going to go over here? I guess interesting. I guess we'll see in the movie. I think he's got a little rocket. Just like I'll join in. Yeah. I'm so amped for this freaking movie. Guys, I can't wait. I'm so excited. And then they just have available on Blu-ray and digital every single one of these freaking movies. Is Captain Marvel already available on digital? I don't know if that's true. Oh, man. That's so exciting. Like, all right, guys, that was another trailer reaction. I hope you enjoyed. I'm going to pass it off now. Just, I got things to do today, so I'm going to put this into Premiere, edit, upload, get it up to you guys so I can head out then. Again, just enjoy what you enjoy. Don't let people stop you from liking your things, unless it's harmful. Like, if you're doing drugs, don't do drugs, kids. Come on. You save your life. But if you enjoy nerdy stuff, movies, games, reading, whatever, just do it. Don't let people ruin your life, okay? I love you guys. Please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, etc., etc., and I will see you guys later.